Would you like to know what accounts contractors would use in their chart of accounts? Well, let us show you in this episode of QuickBooks Online for Contractors. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Now you may well ask, what is the chart of accounts? Well, it's the general ledger of the company. It's a set of records where each record is a category of transactions. Each record is called an account. You need a separate record or account for each income type of transaction, and you need a separate account for each expense type of transaction, and you need a separate account for each bank account type of transaction and credit card type of transaction that you have in your company. Each transaction type gets recorded in two accounts that match the category of that transaction. In the days before the computer, the general ledger was a notebook. You can see on the left, it was like a book where each page in the book was an account that represented something you had to account for. Nowadays, in QuickBooks Online, we call that set of records the chart of accounts. And it's the same idea, except it's in the computer. QuickBooks Online gives you a sample chart of accounts to work with from the beginning. The accounts that QuickBooks Online gave you when you signed up are what most companies need. Expense type of accounts have names of expenses that most companies would have as they operate, so they're trying to save you a little time and help you out. You must add the ones that you need for your specific company, and that's what we're going to do now. So, you may well ask, what information is needed when you add accounts to your chart of accounts? Well, you have to tell QuickBooks the names of the accounts that your specific company needs in order to add it to the list. And whatever name you put, and exactly how you put it, is the way those accounts will show up on the reports, like the profit and loss and the balance sheet. You also have to put in account type. An account type will determine how the account will behave, or more specifically, what you can do with that account. Now, QuickBooks Online adds this extra piece of data that you also have to tell QuickBooks when you put in another account in the chart of account. It's called detail type, and it's usually not relevant. It's just used to clarify exactly how you're going to use that particular account. Now, account type can be explained this way. Account type is explaining to QuickBooks how the account will behave or what you can do with that account. For example, only bank type of accounts will be available in the write checks window because you would only record checks from a bank type of account, not an income type of account or any other type of account. Only credit card type of accounts will be available to choose when recording credit card payments and credits in the credit card window. Only income type of accounts will show up at the top section of the profit and loss to show your total income, and of course expense type of accounts will show up at the bottom of your profit and loss to show what you spent and so on. So hopefully that's enough to get started, just to get the idea of what account type is. Now here we are in QuickBooks Online, and to open the chart of accounts, you click Accounting, Chart of Accounts. And if it's the very first time that you're going to the chart of accounts in this account, you'll see this little picture here, and you have to click See Your Chart of Accounts. Now, Here are all the accounts that QuickBooks Online has already put on your account list in order for you to manage your company. And if you scroll down, you see where it starts by expenses. Most of these expense names are very common expenses that typical companies would have. If you scroll up, you see it only gave you one generic sales income account that we're going to manage. And of course, it gives you some other things that other companies usually do, use when they manage their company. Now, here are the actual accounts that we're going to add that we will need to use in our company. So we will leave on the list most of the accounts that QuickBooks put and just add the ones that we need. And when we add them, we'll put the name in capital letters so that it will be clear that that is an account that we added, not an account that automatically came with QuickBooks Online. So the first one is named Cash in Bank, and it's a bank checking type of account. So how would you add a new account? Well, scroll to the top of the Chart of Accounts window and click New, and you get the Add Account window. The first one, the type is bank, and the detail type is checking. After you choose the type and detail type, then put the name Cash in Bank. Actually, capital letters. Now, notice if you click Save and Close, here it is added to the account list in the Chart of Accounts, and you could make it inactive, which means remove it, or you can edit it. If you click Edit, you can go back there and change the type or the name or anything that QuickBooks allows you to change. Let's add income from plumbing work as an income service income account. So scroll to the top, New. It's an income type of account. It's service income, and we will call it income from plumbing. I think income from plumbing services, let me see what it is. Yes, income from plumbing work, actually, excuse me. Income from plumbing work. You know, the name can be anything the owner wants it to be, as long as when she or he looks at it on the report, they know what it is. And we don't have to click Save and Close. We can click the pull-down arrow and click Save and New, and it will save us time when we add the next one. Income from electrical work. So, again, this is income, and this is service income, and the name is income from electrical work. And click Save and New. When it comes to the two expenses that we're going to add, just put other expense in the detail type, because it's really not relevant in our case. So we're going to choose expense and come down to about the middle where it says other business expenses. And then we'll put job supplies expense. Save and New. And again for the last one, delivery expense will be other business expense. So we scroll down expense, other business expenses, and this will come up here as delivery expense. Okay, on the last one, you can click Save and Close. And now we've added the accounts that we need, and the rest of the accounts that we need should already be here. But you should know, you can reopen and edit any account if you made a mistake. And as I showed you, if I made a mistake on, for example, Cash in Bank, I would come to this list and click the pull down and choose Edit. That would bring me back to the window where I could change type, detail type, or the name. And lastly, you should know that you can remove accounts that you don't need by clicking to make them inactive. And you would click in the same place. So for example, if we don't need inventory asset, which in our case we don't, we could come to the right, click this, and click make inactive. And we click, are you sure you want to inactivate this? Click yes. Now it's gone from the list and we don't have to deal with it at all. So that's how you put in the chart of accounts, and that's what accounts are.